The key to riding an avalanche train is preparation. I'm going to show you how throughout this virtual training series. These are proven effective techniques. I'll be sharing my 24 years of instructing experience in short segments that get right to the point. Jeremy was aware of the conditions, approached cautiously, and kept his eyes on the train above him. His extensive avalanche training made all the difference on this day. On the surface, it's not a problem. Once it's buried, it can prevent the layer above it and below it from bonding. The weak layer can remain in the snowpack for weeks and even longer, thus the name, persistent weak layer. They're just a recipe for disaster. One problem is there may be no signs of instability. The persistent weak layers just need a trigger. What's the trigger? Additional weight on the hill. You hitting the weak spot or the thin spot on the slope with persistent weak layers, tracks on the hill doesn't mean it's safe. Usually it means someone hasn't hit the weak spot. We stay off the terrain with this problem. We wait until things stabilize. Doesn't mean we don't ride, we just have to pick our terrain carefully. Watch your slope angle. Watch what's above you. Are you in the run out for an avalanche? Here's a video from Doug Chabot from the Gallatin National Forest Avalanche Center.
I'm here at the south end of Henderson Ridge in Cook City, where a snowmobiler triggered this huge slide that broke 15 feet deep. This happened 3 days ago. It tapers down to about a foot and a half at its thinnest areas. And one of the questions we ask ourselves when we're up here in these huge slides is, where can you trigger this from? Because you're not going to trigger it at its deepest spot, you're going to trigger it where it's thin. And on this slope, there's a lot of rocky, thin areas where a snowmobiler can collapse that weak layer. That weak layer can propagate across the slope underneath these huge wind slabs. The weak layer that we're finding on the ground is all over the place. And so we're really concerned with spots that have this wind load over the weak layer, above tree line, up at higher elevations where it's exposed, because our standard things like digging a snow pit is not gonna help. A snow pit wouldn't have helped in this situation. So avoidance and being really careful is kinda what we have to do.
So here's a tip of the day, a phone weather app. I use my radar. So this shows precipitation, and what it shows you is where the storms are, gives you a time lapse. Darker the color, the more precipitation you're getting. This is really good in the winter for figuring out which areas are getting the snow. Also, all these moving lines here, that's the winds. No weather, clear day, and look at the winds coming out of the southeast. Let's have a recap of today. Persistent weak layers are responsible for the most avalanche fatalities. Look for them in the avalanche forecast. If persistent weak layers are present and reactive, alter your riding to avoid the areas with the problem. It's the only smart way to manage this problem. Watch your slope angles, watch the runout zones, and be aware of remote triggers. Thanks for watching. Next week, we'll be covering more information. Get your riding partners to watch. You want to know this. Here's some links to win prizes and learn more.